Call Me By Your Name is a film that I really wanted to like, yet the first time I tried to watch it, I found myself skipping through the first half hour. Then I gave up on it entirely. Yet before and since I watched it, I was surrounded by people who were full of praise for it. Lots of people cited the cinematography, soundtrack, and sound design as reasons for their praise, and I agreed with them on all of these points, but I still couldn't make it through the film. So when I got the opportunity to rewatch it for class, I was excited. Maybe in this context, I could learn to enjoy this film as much as many of my friends had. This time, I did watch it all the way through, and didn't skip any of it. So now I feel I can reliably say that I do not like Call Me By Your Name. I can also say why. I cannot stand the way Oliver is presented. Armie Hammer's portrayal of Oliver in Call Me By Your Name is conventionally masculine. He's big and strong, he takes up space, and he feels entitled to things. So I was surprised to come across an article titled, Redefining Masculinity, on Armie Hammer in Call Me By Your Name. To show what I'm talking about, I will use a couple of clips as examples. Self-confidence is a trait often seen in Hollywood depictions of masculinity. Stephen Neale writes, narcissism and narcissistic identification both involve fantasies of power, omnipotence, mastery, and control. Oliver exits the house and enters the scene with confidence. He is the first person to speak in the scene, happy to draw attention to himself. Then he grabs the first available chair and sits down without considering whether anyone else was sitting there first. These behaviors show the feeling of power and control that Oliver has, even in the situation he has just entered. No one in the scene is bothered by this behavior. They see it as charming instead of entitled. Even Elio's mother seems happy to have her seat stolen. In another show of power, Oliver doesn't seem to know his own strength when he smashes a soft-boiled egg when trying to open it. Instead of showing him tempering his strength, the film shows the housekeeper opening another one for him. This allows him to eat an egg without breaking the fantasy of power. When he does eat, he does it with no social grace. He shovels food into his mouth. He has no self-consciousness in this situation. He feels at ease and in control. Looking at the breakfast scene, we discuss Oliver as a male power fantasy. Now in the scene of him playing volleyball, we'll discuss him as the object of Elio's sexual desire. In the beginning of the scene, he's in a wide shot, playing volleyball in nothing but a pair of small shorts. Several girls on the sideline discuss his playing and his good looks, echoing Elio's own thoughts. When it comes to discussing bodies shown as sexual commodities in film, women are often the focus. Neale writes, while mainstream cinema, in its assumption of the male norm, perspective, and look, can constantly take women and the female image as its object of investigation, it has rarely investigated men and the male image in the same kind of way. Films invite the viewer to look at female characters voyeuristically. These female characters are most often love interests, and the viewer shares the voyeurism with the main character. In Call Me By Your Name, Oliver is looked at by Elio, and by us. There are also plenty of the masculine power fantasies mentioned earlier in this scene. Throughout the scene, Oliver is a strong audio presence. Even when he's not talking on screen, his shouts can be heard.
Mine.
Oliver grabs a water bottle meant for someone else straight out of Elio's hand in a display of dominance. He then proceeds to give Elio a pretty handsy back rub, which he later admits was his attempt at flirting. Not only does this back rub give Hammer a chance to flex his muscles, it also emphasizes the size difference between him and Timothy Chalamet. In any relationship, there are power dynamics at play, and the one between Oliver and Elio is far from an exception. Oliver is much older and more experienced. He is also physically larger and stronger. While Timothy Chalamet is not effeminate, he has a slight build and delicate features, especially compared to Armie Hammer. I've heard at least one man say he's straight, quote, but Timothy Chalamet. And I've seen the same sentiment repeated several times on Twitter. The makers of Call Me By Your Name used several techniques to portray Oliver's masculinity. The first is casting. Armie Hammer is a large man, especially compared to Timothy Chalamet. The second is sound design. Oliver is a loud and demanding character. He speaks louder than most of the characters in the film. During some scenes, like the volleyball scene, he can be heard even when he's not on screen. The third is the costume design. He wears large shirts that highlight his imposing stature. He wears tight shorts that show off the shape of his body. The costume design also effectively utilizes the lack of clothing. The effectiveness and consistency of these techniques showed that Oliver is a purposefully masculine character. So I think that Armie Hammer's Oliver is the reason that I just cannot get behind Call Me By Your Name, despite what a well-made film it is. He is arrogant, big, and loud in a way that's typical of Hollywood portrayals of masculinity. I'm not saying that masculinity is inherently bad, or that Oliver should have been any different in this film. Clearly it worked. So many people love Call Me By Your Name. It just wasn't the film for me.